My name's Aaron Ciotti. Everybody calls me Ciotti. Welcome to hell. Welcome to the show. I gotta put socks on. My fetuses are cold. That's not the right word, is it? Look at these socks. My parents got me these socks for my birthday. It's a crazy sock right there. What you were watching was analog footage from yesterday. And tonight, we are going to edit that with Sony Handycam footage. If you've got an old Sony Handycam and an Immersion RC Power Play, you can plug them into each other and you can record 640x480 OG ass looking 80s, 90s looking Handycam footage in with other stuff. Bunch of people have been doing. Somebody sent it to me. I think it might have been CMYK. Sent me a Instagram reel where the person was like, you know, Handycam plus Immersion RC Power Play, and then they had a bunch of old, not old. It looks old. It's really cool. It's a real vibe. That word is so goddamn stale already. I'm not gonna do it if I'm not using Tiny Whoop footage. Like, it make, so this is 640 for anybody that doesn't know, this is 640x480. Trying to find the tapes is really, really difficult. Oh wow, look. Tell me there's not a tape in here. There's a tape in here! I didn't show you guys that, but it popped the thing open. Yeah, apparently finding these tapes is a little bit difficult. Plus, like, why would you want to record to a tape? That's insane. Go ahead. There it goes. a relic from ye olden days. Unbelievably, the Sony batteries still work. Oh, that's because it's a lithium battery. Wow. I wonder if it's an... I guess it's an early LiPo. But, yeah. So, at the drift... Look, it's got night shot, bro! Up here, there's a infrared LED. And, I think when you flip the... It's like a physical... Oh, hold on. Sorry, guys. Haven't been able to hear me. I think it physically raises and lowers a infrared filter. I can probably see it in there. No, I can't see it in there. But yeah, without the infrared filter, infrared LEDs are relatively bright. So yeah, that's the plan for tonight. The grip is all flaking off and shit. Hi, Maggie! So yeah, I've got all that footage downloaded to the hard drive, and I don't know, maybe it'll be cool. I've chosen a song that has sort of like a 90s, 2000s feel to it, and, yeah, should be fun. What do you think of that? What do you think of that? Sky High Charlie says, I still have the Canon ZR850, don't know if it even works. I have a Canon as well. I've got the Canon ZR500. I haven't fired this one up yet. It was just, you know, the Handycam was the bigger one, and I was like, bigger's better! I didn't actually say or think that. But, yeah, I'm gonna try the Canon next time as well, and we can compare the footage and see what's what. About 15 minutes before this live stream started, the stand on this monitor here exploded, and it fell down and shit flew everywhere on the desk. So I'm slightly out of breath, and it's also hot here. Hold on, I gotta turn a fan on. It is almost like air conditioning hot. So let's get a little fan going here. All right, cool. Just get the air moving in the basement here. So yeah, many things are going on. We're also going to do six batteries, and this is, of course, as they all are, a Q&A live stream. Ask any questions that you've got in the chat, and I will answer them. I read a comment on a previous live stream from, I had asked you guys what you think about the new microphone location here, which is... Man, when the monitor fell, it smacked the microphone. This is a... Yeah, the mic is on an arm that I got for my birthday. And the thought process of the arm is that I can get the mic a little bit closer to me. The problem is I move around a lot. And so... Hear the difference in volume as I move around, the volume changes. Getting a mic really close to your face, you kind of got to stay still, and I don't. We're moving around, we're putting goggles on. When I go over to the bench, the thought process with this arm is that when I go over to the bench, I can swing it across here and then tilt the mic up like that, and then yeah, I thought maybe I could get better audio in both scenarios, but somebody had commented that, yeah, the volume changes a lot because I move around so much. So I have a feeling I'm going to move the mic back to where it was. It used to be right over here, which when I roll over to the workbench, it's kind of there. It's sort of equidistant from my face, and that's really what you want if you're going to be in two different spots. So, but it was worth a shot. It was worth a shot putting it here. If one more person says that they've noticed it and it's not as good now as it was before, I'll definitely do it. If one person says that they like it better this way, well, then we're at 1-to-1. So you guys decide. You're the ones that have to listen to me. I didn't fly all the batteries, so I've still got, it looks like, 2 charged batteries left. I need 4 more. I flew a ton of batteries yesterday at the, chasing the little RC drift cars. I did a whole bunch of
analog batteries, and then I did a bunch of walk snail batteries. We're not going to look at the walk snail batteries today. You guys just got to take a look at two of the analog batteries at the beginning of the stream there. So yeah, that was very fun. I guess that's another problem with having the mic here. It's like I put a ton of stuff like right here, and then so when I'm fondling it and clanging it around, you guys are gonna be able to hear it a lot easier, a lot louder, a lot. Words eluded him. I guess I don't need to put this with the Tiny Whoop stuff. I don't really use this anymore because the HDZero goggles have proper DVR in them. So, yeah, I was about to put this in the little Tiny Whoop box, but it doesn't really make much sense in there. I might as well put it with the camcorder. My mind is so blown that the batteries held up. This thing must be like 15, 20 years old. Not 20 years old. It's probably 15 years old. Might be 20 years old. How old is a Sony Handycam? Look it up. Somebody look it up for me. Tell me how old it is. Tell me how old I am. Let me get a couple of batteries on the charger. I've now flown the Beta FPV Lava batteries and the DogCom 320 mAh batteries, and they're fine. They're all exactly the same. I get the exact same runtime with all of them. But that's a good thing. That means that wherever you're ordering from, they're probably going to have some folded cell BT 2.0s. Buy a bunch. Every time you do an order, buy a bunch of batteries, and then you'll have tons of them. And they don't hold up super, super long. Maybe, I don't know, 50 cycles, 100 cycles before they start to, before the internal resistances start to go crazy. So yeah, have a bunch of them. It just makes sense to have a whole bunch of these batteries so that you can, if you have a whole bunch, it won't feel like they're dying as quickly as they actually are because you'll be able to cycle them in and out. Make sure that you mark them though. One thing that you can do is like mark them with a different colored marker. Another thing that you can do is just order one of every different kind. Order six of the Beta FPV Lavas, order six of the Weebleeds, order six of the DogComs, order, you know what I mean? So that each different run of batteries has different labels on it. The tattoos and the tinywhoop.coms, you probably want to mark them with a marker because, as opposed to marking them with, oh, I don't know, your face, because the stickers are going to peel off over time. The DogCom stickers are a little bit flatter, and then the Beta FPV stickers wrap around like the Weebleed stickers, so those won't peel off as quickly. Where are the rest of the batteries? Is this all that I have? I have been throwing them out. I've a bunch of the batteries have gotten really cycled out, and I've been trashing them. But I only trashed two of them. Five there. Yeah, I guess this is it. I guess this is all of them. What are you guys up to? What's happening in chat? Hockey Rounds was first. Curtis Hayes was next. Metal Dirt Skin, Sky High Charlie, Matt Norton, CH3FPV. Raging Leap, Free Lojo, Beef FPV, Douglas Otwell, Timmons, Northern Tier, Stavel, Rockcrawler, Max Melner, Walter Ramdonko, FPV Toast, Slow Cal, Hillside, Sky High Charlie, Curtis Hayes, Jeremy, J. Deegs. What's up, everybody? Thanks for coming. If you want to talk directly to me in the chat, all you got to do is type CiottiFPV. If you do that for me, it'll light up an orange. CH3 tagged me and said, what's up? Rockcaller said, hiya. Walter said, you look well after party. Thank you, dude. I fell asleep before 5 a.m. last night. It was amazing. Curtis Hayes says, what's the best tiny lifter or lightweight HD cam? Peanut, Insta360, Go 3, or... the Peanut is the same thing as the Insta360 Go 2, basically. And that's currently my favorite. The Insta360 Go 3... is kind of like needlessly heavy, and it's really not much better quality. Speaking of the Insta360 Go 2, over on, here on my channel, I should say, There's a brand new edit that is up of the Sunny King Criterium 2023. And I forgot that I didn't put in here. I did! Look at me go! Hey! Flown with my Category 1 sub-250 live streaming rigs carrying an Insta 360 Go-To. Look at me go! Yeah, here's the link in the chat. Go check it out. My mind is absolutely blown at how good. Every time I edit footage from the Insta 360 Go-To, I'm just staggered. It is so goddamn good for 26 grams. And the software that you put it through on the desktop, the software on the phone that you can put it through, it's just awesome. It's really way better than it should be for something that's so light and is from Insta 360. Although we can't really say that anymore. Insta 360 has been putting out some really good cameras. They used to be like, I don't know, not near as good as GoPro, but man, they've been doing a great job. And they've got a camera, I forget which one it is, but they've got an action cam out now that mountain bikers prefer over the Hero 12, which is awesome, mainly because of the stabilization is amazing. But yeah, very cool stuff. Check out my mailbag, friends. Did I put that in the title of the stream? Scream, great. I did not. Look at me, shit the bed. Whatever, it doesn't have to be in the title of the stream. CMYK sent me some fun stuff in a very, very cool padded envelope. Can't really show you this side, but yeah, super cool. Old school composition book looking. He sent me a creepy little plastic baby that I don't know what to do with, but maybe he could go for a ride on one of the Tiny Whoops or something. And then he sent me a whole bunch of his new tiny little stickers. He's been checking out sticker app instead of Sticker Mule. Apparently, the owner of Sticker Mule makes donations to the Trump campaign, so screw them. Sticker app runs a lot of ads, and already kind of dig them because they'll make small stickers. Sticker Mule, they will not make anything this small. And for your goggles, the bigger stickers don't really work. So yeah, a whole bunch of CMYK stickers. If you win something from a giveaway or if you buy something with me, I will throw in a CMYK sticker for you, which is perfectly sized for goggles, as evidenced by the one that I put front dead center on my walk snail goggles. Look at that. You can get yourself a CMYK sticker by just buying something from me. You can buy something from me by either just messaging me or heading over to CiottiFPV.com. I've got an Etsy store with a bunch of stuff for sale. I've got a Fiverr page where you can work one-on-one with me. I've got a Teespring store, but they're going to drop ship to you. That doesn't come from me. So yeah, I've got a bunch of random stuff for sale that I'll kind of call out on every other stream or so. At the moment, I've got a set of 0802 27,000 kV EX motors with the lightweight ones. It's actually a 33,000 kV bell, but the bells are all the same. It's just, you know, the writing on it. The stator is what matters for KV. So it's a 27,000 kV iGAU motor stator and then an EX bell with like four batteries on it. So these are fresh. Set of those. Hang on. Dog is yelping. You okay, buddy? Eddie? Is he okay? Okay. Jesus, that was not a happy yelp. Hold on, guys. I knocked everything over.
Yikes. That was scary. All right, hang on, guys, hang on. Yeah, that scared the shit out of me. I've not heard
Teddy yelp like that. That was he sounded like he was in a lot of pain. Jesus. Okay. Where were we? Things. Yeah, there's things. If you need something, message me and ask me. I might have it. There's also a set of brand new iFlight Zing 1002 22,000 kV motors for sale as well. Those are just the things that are sitting next to my desk here. I do have more stuff, but whatever. Hillside FPV says, hello, do you have good settings for Velocidrone so that the 5-inch flight is even more realistic? Not really. You do want to screw around with the advanced settings a little bit. You can turn up and down the quad weight, and you can turn up and down the amount of power that it has. Everybody flies a different 5-inch rig. I fly very lightweight rigs on fairly low-powered motors. Most people fly significantly heavier rigs on 2207s that are much more powerful. If I were just to give you my settings, it really wouldn't work for you unless you fly 600-gram all-up weight 2306 rigs. Just dial that stuff in for you until it feels right, and there you go. Kind of like PID tuning. It's worth it to do basically a custom tune in there to dial it in exactly for what you fly. And it's super easy. Just start moving the sliders around, fly it, go back and forth a bunch of times, and you'll get it. Metal Dartskin says, that's the sound of me looking for shit in my FPV pile once a day. Yeah, I feel that. Stavel says, finally a nice day. Got to try out my 3-inch Siren F3 split. You lucky bastard, you. I've been waiting for that to come back in stock. Speaking of, is it in stock yet? Sold out. Nope. Someday. Someday. FPV Toast says, I've been putting scotch tape over my batteries to keep the stickers from getting hung up. Not a terrible idea. Paratino Photography says, the thing that I refuse to say. Wake and Bake says, I have those RCinpower 1002s and they damn sure ain't nothing special. I'm so disappointed in the RCinpower 1002s. Like, they're not bad, but like, so many people were like, oh, these are the best. They perform like they're 30,000 kV. Oh my God. They perform exactly like the Flywoo 1002s and the iFlight 1002s. So, I mean, they are cooler looking. I'll give them that. The pink and teal thing is amazing. But, they're not any lighter. They're not any higher KV. They're completely fine. They're a 1002 22,000 KV motor. There's nothing magical about them. That was kind of disappointing. But what I don't know why I had... I don't know. I don't know why I thought they would be different. Look, like sometimes certain people will say things, and I trust those people. Maybe I shouldn't. Jay Deeg says, I have two Grinderinos and think I've heard you mention you plan on running 3-inch props rather than 3.5. Yep. On your build. What's the reason behind that? Basically, the ratio of all-up weight to the size of the propellers is where the sort of like the flight characteristics come from. I use the words flight characteristics a lot. The bigger the propellers get, the bigger the parachute is. So every time you come off the throttle, if it's a big parachute, it's going to slow down and stop, and then it's just going to fall, and it's going to fall very slowly. That's not the way 5-inch rigs fly. 5-inch rigs, when you come off the throttle, they sail through the air. They've got a lot of weight, and the propellers are big, but they're not that big. Grinderinos typically are going to be anywhere from like 260 to 300 grams. In that weight range, a 3-inch propeller much more closely mimics the flight characteristics of a 5-inch rig than a 3.5-inch prop. With 3.5-inch props, it falls more slowly, and when you come off the throttle, it doesn't want to carry the momentum because it's a bigger parachute. The propellers are always spinning, and so they're always punching a hole in the air. And what you want to remember is that they're, you know, the propeller is here, but from this, you would think, right, like, oh, you know, I come off the throttle and I throw it inverted a lot of the time. It should just sail through the air because the propellers are sitting like this, but they're not. They're always spinning, and the PID loop is always running. So the propellers are pushing a column of air down, and they're also pulling a column of air in. So the area of turbulence, or like, yeah, it's just a parachute. It's disturbing air like this, top and bottom as well. So even if you're inverted sailing like this, it's still smacking a big hole in the air, and a bigger propeller is going to punch a bigger hole through the air. And so, yeah, 3-inch props at 260, 270, 280, 290 grams. I just like the way that flies. That's more of a that more closely mimics these guys, and that's what I try to do. I try to build everything to fly as similar as possible. I don't like rigs where you come off the throttle and they just hit a brick wall, and I also don't like rigs that when you come off the throttle they take forever to fall out of the sky. That requires me to fly them completely different and really adjust the way that I fly versus what I'm more used to. This is what I used to be used to, but I haven't flown 5-inch much lately. But I still do it. I still build them to fly as closely to these as I possibly can. So yeah, that's it. If you want more power and more runtime, use 3.5-inch props. They will give you both of those things. But what they will not give you is... Nah, we just talked about it. Timmons says, RunCam Thumb Pro 4K versus Insta 360 Go 2. Which one comes out on top? There's almost no comparison. The Insta 360 Go 2 looks absurdly good. They've got their own software that makes it super easy to horizon lock it, stabilize it, all the good stuff. But you pay for it, right? Insta 360 Go 2, you're probably going to pay $200 on eBay for them. RunCam Thumb Pro 4K is unbelievably good for the price, but if you want to stabilize it, you got to monkey around with gyro flow. The quality is just not nearly as good as the Insta 360 Go 2. So yeah, if you're on a budget, RunCam Thumb for sure. It is the king of value for money. But if you've got the money for it's also lighter. The RunCam Thumb is super, super, super lightweight. I think it's like 5 or 6 grams. The Insta 360 Go 2 is 26 grams. So massive difference in weight. But yeah, the Insta 360 Go 2 is a significantly better camera with much better support. Jeremy says, what am I up to? I busted the UFL off my Mobula 6 HDZero. God damn it. Was trying to check the antenna due to snow. Ended up breaking the trace. Tried to repair and still back to snow. Went only a room away. That sucks, dude. Apparently, though... Oh, wait, no. Caddx and Walksnail, they repair stuff. I'll bet you that HDZero repairs stuff, too. Shoot HDZero an email. Tell them that the UFL broke off and ask them if they can fix it. I bet you they will. Jay Hines says, upgraded to Hex 0802 30,000 kV motors on my Meteor 75. When I power up the whoop goes on its back props. What? It goes up on its back props, number one and number three. What should I check on? Goes up on its back props. The only thing I can think of. I'm trying to think of what that means. The only thing I can think of is that, by the way, all the whoop flight footage that we're going to watch tonight was on one of these little analog guys with the batwing mount. What I'm assuming that you mean is when you arm it and throttle it up, It only makes thrust in the rear. What's probably happening is that you said you changed the motors. Your front motors are probably spinning the wrong direction. So go into the motors tab of Betaflight, do the motor direction wizard, and make sure that all your motors are spinning the right direction. Also make sure that the front props are on correctly. If it only makes thrust in the rear is what's happening, then yeah, there you go. Matt Norton says, I'd take the 1002 motors. Shoot me a message and they're all yours, brother. I'm selling them for whatever they are new. It's either 12 or 13 bucks per new because they are brand new. I ran two batteries on them. Stavel, YouTube did the thing. Hang on. Stavel says, Xnova 1804 on my Grinderino build. I do not love the Xnovas. Really? Why not? They are my absolute favorite micromotor. And they're what's on my build as well. Marshmallow Hunter says, hello. Paratino Photography says, do you PID tune for a heavy front mounted camera? I'm assuming the question is PID tuning necessary for a heavy front mounted camera? Maybe. It depends on the powertrain. If you've got powerful enough motors, if you've got a powerful enough combo of propellers, motors, battery voltage, you might not need to. If not, you might. It really depends on the specific build, which is kind of always the case. But the tuning that you might need to do is to push the pitch tracking sliders. The second to last and third to last sliders will add PID gains to just the pitch axis, and that heavy camera up front is only on the pitch axis, right? It's not an offset camera. I'm assuming it's right on the front, the center line of the rig. So roll PIDs don't need to really adjust at all. The way that I check it, you know, that's the scenario on both of these, well, all three of these actually, Cinesplores, is that you do flips on the roll axis and you push the PIDs, you push the general PIDs until the roll axis doesn't bounce back and feels good. And then you do front flips and back flips. And what you'll usually find is that on front flips and back flips, you'll get bounce back. And then so that's where you want to push just the pitch PID gains to take care of that bounce back on the pitch axis. And what you're trying to do is get the pitch axis to where it performs identical to the roll axis. But do the roll axis first, because you can do the roll axis with the first two sliders, D gain and P and I gain. Or the easy button is just to use the master multiplier. And so move those up until the roll axis is good. It might already be good at the stock PIDs. Depends, again, on the powertrain. So do those first, because as you're pushing the master multiplier or just the PI and D sliders, those are also going to push the pitch sliders up. And you don't want to push the roll sliders any farther than you need to. So you're going to basically move pitch and roll at the same time until roll is good, and then you're going to push pitch beyond that. That's what you're looking at doing there. Jay Hines says, like standing on its feet. Yeah, I think I know what you mean. I think your front motors are either spinning the wrong direction or the props are on backwards. Jay Hines says, I'll double-check motors with Betaflight. Thanks, you're certainly welcome. Timmons says, are those Blue Bell 0802s 1mm or 1.5mm shaft? They are 1mm shaft. These are the Bells from the 0802 EX 33,000 kV Imoptera or Epamera or whatever the hell they're called motors, which are a 1mm motor shaft. I took the stator is from an iGAL 27,000. These motors are the net result of me taking the 33,000 kV stator and then the iGAL motor bell with a 1.5mm motor shaft, and making a set of motors for the, it was the, well, here they are, is the 802s for the, for the walk snail rig that didn't work out. So now I'm going to put them onto an analog Jungle Gym Basher, and we'll see how long those last. Stavel says, I do like the Xnovas. They are great. Okay. Real. Oh, you said, I do love the Xnovas. For some reason, I saw the... Yeah. You do love them. Awesome. Good. You better. Rob Oxison says, Hola, Gangle Commander. Hey, this shirt is available and many more over on the Teespring store. We didn't always call ourselves the Gangly Gang. We used to call ourselves the Collective for the first couple of years of this live stream because, yeah, we share information and act like the Borg Collective, yo. Rob Oxison says, I'll try to check in after dinner. Sounds good. Matt Norton says, message sent for the 1002s. Sounds good. And we're caught up on chat, which is good because editing takes forever. And I forgot to start the project. So here we go. Where's Premiere? Do I really not have Premiere in the dock? That's weird. All right, Premiere is firing up here. I'm not going... So if you're going to be working with 640 by 480 footage, there is no reason to have Premiere make proxies from anything. So you can save yourself some time and hard drive space when you set up your project here to not have it create proxies. If you're working with 2.7K, 4K footage, this looks different. Why does this look so different? What the hell? I guess this is the newer version of Premiere. Okay, hold on. Project name. So we're going to do we're going to do 2024-4- what was yesterday, the 18th? 18 RC Drift for the name of the project. Project location, no. Yeah, this is, okay. This Premiere looks totally different, and I'm not completely sure where you would even turn the proxies on. I wanted to show you where you would turn those on, but I, I'll find it. Hold on. Copy media. Is it in copy media? Reset? No, that's not it. Create new sequence? No. What the hell, Adobe? Project template? No. It would automatic transcription? Hell no. It would make sense that it would be in copy media? Nope, that ain't it. What about organize me? Nope. Well, shit. Somewhere in here you can tell it to create proxies. Proxies are smaller versions of the flight, not the flight, but the video files. Wow, this sucks. What the hell, Premiere? Okay, I would just Google where do I create proxies in the new version of Premiere. This is super annoying. This is version 24.2.1. And I don't like it already. But that's okay. Yeah, there's some way of doing it. I'm just not seeing it here anywhere. What is this shit? Tutorial? Get this the fuck out of here. Wow, I'm super annoyed that... I don't know. Whatever. Everybody changes everything all the time. Stavel says, do you know why Premiere sometimes doesn't export audio, but plays audio in preview? Probably because Premiere is super buggy. So don't give too much thought to it. Just Google the problem that you're having, and someone will be having that same problem. And you can empathize with them. All right, and let's pull some media in here. All right, that's going to take a minute. Hopefully it doesn't fire up the media encoder. And it did not. Awesome. So I picked a song that has some... Here's a little hack for you. The first file that you drag into the timeline, it's going to set... It's going to make the sequence settings... it's going to basically use that file for the sequence settings. So... you just have to go in and fix it, but yeah, that's a little tip that'll save you some time. All right, so there's something in there. Now let's pull some audio. Go in, and I'm going to mute the audio track that the HDZero stuff actually records audio, which is kind of cool. But I'm going to mute it because I don't want it. And so let's see. Works well. All right, great. Terrific. Off to a fantastic start. Okay. Apparently Premiere can't handle even... See, it's trying to launch Adobe Media Encoder. So it looks like Premiere is now automatically creating proxies, which is interesting. I don't like that at all. Oh, Jesus Christ. Come on, man. Stop. There we go. Wow, Premiere is really bad sometimes. I do need to learn to use DaVinci Resolve at some point. Apparently it's just so much better than Premiere. Maybe we're not editing tonight, friends. Okay. What the hell? Oh my God, Media Encoder keeps fucking opening. Stop! Jesus. All right, well, the computer is just shitting its pants. Stavel says, no, we got that. Wow. All right, hold on. Oh, I have a bunch of other shit open. That's probably why. I still have Photoshop opened. Hang on. Oh, even Lightroom is still opened. No, I don't need to save that. Get out of here. Do you need to save that though? Okay. All right. So yeah, Adobe Media Encoder is brutal. And so that's what was locking everything up on us. But it also doesn't help that like every single Adobe program is running right now. Come on, finish saving, you jerk. All right, come on, there we go. Great, terrific. So here's the song. Yeah, so come on now. You can't tell me that doesn't sound like camcorder footage. One of the best... All right, so I'm going to actually delete that. I just wanted to pull that in to get some of that shit going on. Okay, so let's grab all of this footage here from the Handycam, and we're going to start chopping it up. And why are you so small? That's... what she said. Interesting. Okay, so it grabbed some weird sequence settings. Hold on. Let me see something here. Let me put... Oh, God, no. Stop it. Oh, my God. I'm so sorry for that. Let's do it again. Good idea. Weird. Weird that it grabbed... Okay, hold on. Let's take a look at the sequence settings. Yeah, so it's... Huh. So, HDZero... 60 frames a second is correct, but it's coming in at 1280 by 720. That's kind of interesting. I don't know why it's doing that. Okay. That's fine. So, I usually have to Google it, but there is a way to change a bunch of sequence settings all at once. Multiple... Oh, yeah, I remember. So... All right, hold on. So what you do is you select one, and then you make the changes that you want. So we're going to blow this up. All right, so 150%. Yeah, that makes sense. So that is now good. And then I think you click... Where do you click? You click here, I think, and then you hit copy. Open Apple C or Control C, and then I believe what you do is select all, and then you click up in here and you paste. And I think that, no, that's not how you do it. Shit. You click somewhere in here. Oh, yeah, you click, I think you click here, up in this little bit here, copy, and then... Select multiple, click in here, and then paste. I think that's it. I think that's how you do it. Let's see. Nope. I told you. I usually have to Google it. Is it right click? Oh, there it is. You right click up here. Okay, yeah. So under FX motion, you right click, and then you do copy here. I think that's it. And then you can select multiples. Nope, that's not it either. Damn it! Oh! It worked! Something happened. It worked. It was in there. Hold on. Ah, there it is! Okay, you just select these. Oh, nice! Okay. So you just select all, and then just hit paste. And then... Hey, there it is. Okay, so that's it. That's how you do it. Don't ask me to show you again. Not totally sure what I did. All right, so let's start chopping up this camcorder footage, yo. All right, so you guys are gonna get super annoyed by the music, but I can turn it down a little bit here. We don't really need to be... Listen, yeah, all right, so that's fine. It's nice and low. Look at this shaky-ass camcorder footage. Yeah, baby! It just sells it, man. It just sells it on that 90s look. All right, so I only did that one little pass? What's wrong with me? All right, so I got this one little pass. Let's get it cut from right around here. So let's just drag that out like that, and then this is gonna be cool. The beginning of the song is this is gonna be cool. I think this is gonna be really fun because the beginning of the song sells this like super shitty like yeah, just shitty. And then when the song kind of comes in, we'll get to the flying footage, which will still look shitty, but it'll I don't know. It'll have a nice little punch to it. Yeah. Here we go. All right, so we're gonna just take a little bit of this guy here. About it. I don't want this guy in the frame. All right, so we're gonna take it from there, and then we're gonna ripple delete here, and then we'll just take this little bit we'll chop it there. Okay, cool. So away we go. Probably gonna kill this. No, here we go. Yeah, that'll be cool. Yeah, look at that. This is I'm actually really excited for this. Like, I don't know. It could be unwatchable, but I don't think it will be, because there's just, like, I don't know. This time the 90s are just such like a cool time period, you know? And like, I don't know. I just think this will be really neat. Okay. Chop that down a little bit there. On to the next. Must be 90s week. Nappy just uploaded a video with Roughneck and McLate. Nice. Yeah, man. The 90s are the best. I don't care what anybody says. Ooh, this song is going to be so good. I've put like 2 hours into... Uh-oh. Oh, okay. Something happened with the... Why did it cut off the end of the song? That's very weird. Okay, now we're fine. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what I was just saying. come on, here we go. That sucks, because it's just that guy's back. Hold on, do I have a little... Why is your back so big, sir? We'll chop in a couple little people clips. I think I'm going to lose this Yoakumo because it's just... Or Yakumo, whatever the hell it is. All right. This is a cool little one, though. We got a couple little reactions here. All right. So let's chop there. And chop it there. This can go. And now let me grab a little bit out of the beginning here. I think I'm going to get rid of all this at the beginning. Meditor Itzen says, Bot was going for that 90s skate vid look with the whole 28 grams whoop edit. I think it works. Yeah. That's right. He did a great job on that. That edit was awesome because of it. Look, like, you know, it's such a perfect example of like, image quality means nothing. Like, if what you're pointing the camera at is good, that's what matters. And, yeah. That's all I have to say about that. Yeek! Alright, maybe I'll keep that little whip pan in there, but the rest of this is gone. Get out of here. I also find it absolutely amazing that we're using the most sophisticated, well, I mean, not the most, but like extremely sophisticated video editing software to chop up 640x480 footage. That's just the greatest thing in the world to me. All right, that's a nice little segment there that I'll chop down more. Ripple delete. And the fact that this is, like, totally handheld and, like, not on any kind of a gimbal or anything like that really works. Again, just because the footage looks like hell anyway. It might look weird. Like, this filmed, like, on a nice gimbal, real smooth, might look weird. It might look really cool, but it might actually look weird. Ooh, there's a cool little rotation in there. We might, Northern Tier says, so why are we spending so much money for HD? Yeah, good question. HD can very easily become like a crutch. Like image quality can become a crutch, right? Like, good filmmakers are good filmmakers if it's 640x480 or if it's 1000K. And so, yeah, always remember that. Like, don't try really hard not to get tied up in the, in the Cold War of image quality. Mm-hmm. That's kind of nice there. I wish I'd hit record a second earlier. A little skeleton cart. There's going to be a couple good ones in here. This is a big chunk of video now, so this is going to be a little bit annoying to sift through. But there's going to be a couple good little runs in here. I was even using the handheld zoom and shit. All right, so this is me just getting warmed up. Yeah, there we go. This is cool too because I've only a lot of people do handheld. Most people film these little RC drift cars handheld, and they do some really cool stuff, and it looks really good. I haven't done it yet. All my edits have been only flight footage, which is very different. So this will be really cool to incorporate a little bit of handheld. Yeah, there we go. That was a nice little push in and then catch. So we're going to grab this little bit here. God, those headlights are bright. All right, and then we're gonna, I'm cutting it pretty loose right now, and then I'll come back in and trim it down. These are not at all where the finished cuts are gonna be. I cut to the music, so trimming it loose like this is really nice, because then I can come back. I should have let them go through the frame. It's always tempting to track them at all times, but it looks really good when you let stuff that's moving left to right enter the frame and exit the frame. This is me moving. So hold on. Let me get one more clip from when I was sitting in this spot. And then we'll pick which one is the best afterwards. Ah, that's a good little one. That's a good little one. Yeah. That'll be our second little slip slap here. And I'm going to get it right on this push in. Kill that. Yeah, there we go. There's a nice little hippie hoppy. I totally blew that one, but that's okay. All right, here we go. We're going to move and I'm holding the camera sideways as hell. Come on now. All right, so let's chop it here just to pull this over in the timeline a little bit. Ooh, wow, I'm almost out. That's okay. The beginning of the song is really short. But I might bring some of this footage in again wherever the song kind of chills out a little bit. That's a nice little, if I chop it just right, yeah, there's a little, chop it right here, and then, there we go, and I do want to kill it before the skeleton car comes in. Oh man, so shaky. This is back before they had any kind of decent stabilization, but it works, man. Oh, yeah. There's a little bit of love there. Yeah, here we go. So we're gonna come here. I'm gonna kill all this, right? Yeah, kill all this. We got a nice little one there. Yeah! I should have let him go out of frame. There's a perfect example where I should have let that car go out of frame right there. I should have left it. But that's okay, we'll edit around it. Just fix everything in editing, it's fine. Alright, cool. So that's good, and there should be another file. Yep, there it is. And now I moved over by the window. Alright. That's not terrible. Ooh! Yeah, yo! I haven't run like a handheld camera like this in forever. I used to love doing this. back in the 1900s. All right, so we're gonna. Yeah, no, cause they're. Yeah, they're shallow there. All right, so we're gonna kill it here. And oh, I might grab another little bit right there. Yeah, there's a nice little bit right there, right here. Start here. And ripple delete. By the way, I'm doing an editing stream here because someone commented, when's the next time you're going to do an editing stream? And I was like, wow, I didn't think anybody liked them. I'll do one right now. But also, I've been wanting to play around with the camcorder thing. It's just perfect. Kismet. All right, let's see if we can grab one or two more. And I'm going to cut these really tight, for the record. Ooh! Yeah! Oh, now we're talking, yo! So, let's chop that. And we'll pull this down here. Oh, no. Yeah, I'm gonna tighten this up on the M3. Yeah, here we go. So gonna be right here, and then cut that out. So yeah, it's gonna start there. I'm gonna track the M3 around. Yeah, oh, I love that. That's a good little bit there. I'm gonna learn a lot here too. I'm gonna learn a lot about what looks good filming these guys handheld. Right, I've never done this before, so this is gonna be a huge learning experience. We kind of pan past them when we're doing the other stuff, so I'm going to get rid of this. This can go. Anything decent here in the end? Nah, they just wreck. All right, cool. So let's kill that. And last little bit here. Walter says they need Kamar seals on cycling. This also okay, other side of FPV hobby, clipping and cutting. What's Kamar seals? Kamar's reels? What's that? Oh, yeah. Altitude Raceway is like the one main guy that runs this, so he's gotta get... I gotta show him a little bit of love there. Yeah. Alright, so we're gonna take this middle one right here. So, let's chop it like this. And that. Okay, perfect. And that's it. That's our handheld footage. I do want to take a look at super quick, like, what happens when I make this. So the Immersion RC Power Play records in 60 frames a second. I'm assuming that the camcorder is not sending 60 frames a second. It is not. So the easy way to tell is to slow it down 50% and then just arrow over. Arrow, 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 right? So it's skipping frames. So yeah, it's only coming in at 30, which makes sense. But what's really cool is HDZero and just analog in general is 60 frames a second. So if we do that same thing, what the hell is this? Was flying out front? Oh, it was flying outside the house. We don't need that. So is that. I got a bunch of footage I didn't mean to grab in here. Nope. There we go. Okay. So if we do the same thing, but with some flight footage, where's speed? There it is. 50%. And now if we arrow across, arrow, 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 oh, I'll be damned. This is actually only 30. This camera on here must only be 30 frames, I guess. Every time I've done this previously with analog footage, it's been in proper 60 frames. That's kind of annoying. I don't love that. But whatever. It's okay. This is not
yesterday. I don't remember that car being there yesterday. It's the right layout. Hold on. Where's this from? No, yeah, this is definitely not yesterday. I was not wearing that yesterday. Okay, hold on. Let me figure out. It's also very dark. 189. There must have been other files on the card. This is not it. Whatever. Stop it. Stop trying to launch media encoder, you fuck. Oh my god. What's happening? What? Yeah, great. Get it out. All right, what's this? Just static, all static. All static. Great. Get it. Come on, man. Stop. Jesus Christ on a cracker. What's this? Okay, 1 second. Bye-bye. More static. Get rid of it. Wow, there's a bunch of junk footage. Here we go. Okay, so let's see. Speed, 50%. Pray for not doubled frames. No, doubled frames. Look at that. Shit. What I think maybe that means is that the BI camera is only 30 frames. This is weird. The analog edit that I have up, it's a whole bunch of 60 frame per second analog stuff. Weird. Very, very weird. That's okay. Let's get to proper editing. Well, we can dive into the beginning and chop it up to the music. Let's do that. Let's start to cut this stuff down a little bit. And then, yeah, because it's already 10 after 8, Jesus. Okay, so what are we going to start with? What are we going to start with? So now we're diving into kind of like storytelling. Oh, that's not a terrible idea there. It's got the signs on there. Okay, so we'll maybe lead with that. I like that. Okay. We'll put these guys in here somewhere. We've also got that altitude raceway sign. Okay, then we got all that. Here's the altitude raceway sign. Let's pull that forward. Okay. So, I don't know. Let's just throw these and see what it looks like. Yeah. Yeah, we're already in it. Here we go. We in this. This is gonna be fucking cool. Yeah, okay. I am very excited. This is gonna be cool. Shit. This is like bringing me back to like editing handheld footage. It's so different than editing flight footage. All right, so let's start whopping this stuff around here. Actually, here, let me pull this. Oh my God, media, stop! Media player, oh, why do you keep doing it? Go away, die, burn. Jesus. Okay. Yeah, this is me realizing that my face is in the way down in the corner here. And you guys might not be able to see what the hell I'm doing. So, okay. Oh, this is, I'm so excited about this. I think I'm gonna lead with this. I think this is the, I think this needs to be the little opening here. So we're gonna do a slow fade.
This is too good, man. It's too good because it's just so shitty, but, like, it's perfectly shitty. Like... It's just, I don't know, man. I love this so much. All right, I need that to be a little bit longer. Let's see what that looks like. Hold on. Let's just go up here. Yeah! Okay, that works. That's fine. I got this big, long run down the cars here, which might be cool. Hold on. That's a bit much at the end there. Let's pull this and then open up the beginning a little bit more. Yeah! sometimes editing is great, man. In general, I don't like editing, but every once in a while, it does make me smile, I will admit. And this is one of those times. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, this is going. This is gross. Just a little bit. Yeah, no reason for that. Get that out of there. What's this guy? That'll work. Just pull this another tiny little bit. Move these guys down. Let's see. Ah, now we're putting that one in there first. Okay. And all right, I'm gonna chop the beginning of this off so that here's a little thing. All right, the beginning of this. There's an look. So there's motion the whole time, right? A little bit of motion. Motion, serious motion, serious motion. Still moving. Bunch of motion here. Ready? Ugh. See how it just dies because I was holding the camera in the same spot there? Get rid of that. Chop this front bit off where we're just sitting there, and now watch how much better this looks. Ready? Right? You gotta, you kind of think about the end of the previous clip running into it, right? Like, if the end of the previous clip I'd paused, I might have been able to pull that off. But if the end of the previous clip has, you know, panning or tracking or stuff like that, you want to mix that in with the next chunk of footage. And shorten this up a little bit. Pull this over. Oh, we're almost there. This is great because this is all like stuff in like the pits or paddock. Same deal. See it like, it just stops. Cut the beginning off. This is Premiere. Somebody asked what editing software. But don't use Premiere. Use DaVinci Resolve. It's better. I know Premiere. And I hate editing so much that I don't want to learn something new. Oh, buddy, we're there. All right, so I'm going to save the rest of this stuff for maybe a part of the song that's kind of more chill. So I'm going to move it way the hell out here. And now we're going to dive into some flight footage. And I'm going to really quickly, I just want to chop something up so that we can get a little bit of, like, impact for the first time that we're were watching and listening to this. Hold on. All right, so we've already kind of shown. Hold on, this should be cool. I want to get right into it, though. I want to pick a really strong little bit to start off with. Yeah, this is like when nobody was inside. Hold on. Let me put this up and just push it out. Let me grab something from where I was kind of warmed up already and flying half decent, maybe. Let's just take the very last file. In theory, that's got some good stuff in it. There's actually a little bit. Oh, this is it. Wow, no shit. Okay. I wonder if this will work. Here, hold on. Check this out. I wonder if this will work. This is actually exactly what I had in mind. All right, let's see. I can send. How do I send the audio? Here, I want to give you guys like the full. Badonkadonk. Black hole. Will that send you? Yeah, fine. Whatever. Will that send you guys? Here, let's see. No. It needs to go straight into chase footage. That run up doesn't really work. That's okay though. Let's pick a little bit here. All right. Something where they're kind of moving and grooving. Let's get this figured out here. Oh, that might be it. That might be it. Yeah. Oh, that's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. Yep. That's what we're coming in on. And so where are we going to get this started here? We're going to get it started right there on that little swoopy boy. There it is. Here we go. This will be fun. Hey. Ho. Hey. Yeah. Ho. Hey. Yo, oh, hey, yeah, woo, oh, what a run! yeah, that's it, that's a run right there. And then we're gonna end it right there. Okay, and let's pull this up, reverse this. Not reverse it, but just swap that out. Okay, here we go. This is the real beans. Here comes King Beans, not Brandon. Wow, your computer has to really suck ass to not even be able to handle 640x480. I don't know what to do. Like, is it loud? Why is it so loud? Thanks to me.
fuck. Okay, I don't know. I guess I do have to do proxies for 640x480 footage. What an embarrassment to all Apple products. Okay. Wow. I mean, the proxies will be really small. Yeah, wow. It's what a worthless. Well, I will say this. I have created this project on one of the spinny hard drives. So, yeah. That's not helping anything. Well, yeah, that was a poor choice. Although it should still be able to handle it, but that's where I'm at. Jesus. Travix AU says, or maybe a modern Mac, old Intel Mac sucks sadly. This Mac is 1 year old. Yeah. Well, I guess let's just. It's hard to know if it's working. Yeah, I don't know. Whatever. That's a good run. Let's keep farting around with some other runs. This that would have been such a good run if I could have just locked right onto him. Although, yeah, it gets ruined by that, so that's fine. This is all gonna go away. I'm gonna delete all this. Hold on, let me get caught up on the chat real quick. Cole Power says, analog camera is NTSC, 60 hertz field, update rate interlaced for 30 frames per second. Kilo Zebra says, NTSC signal is 60 fields per second, and each field is only half of the lines. Your DVR is combining every pair of alternate fields in the deinterlacer, leaving only 30 frames per second. Then how does this exist? How was I able to do this then? Where the hell is it? Edit. Nope, there it is. How is this a thing then? What the fuck? That's not what I clicked on at all. Yeah. Like, that's 60 frames. How is this a thing? You know what I mean? It's wiggling up and down a little bit because that's how the, that's just sort of how analog video works. But yeah, I've done 60 frames in the past. Why not now? Strange. That sucks. I mean, it calls. Hold on, let me see. Where's the? Yeah, it thinks it's $59.94. Yeah, so the HDZero goggles are recording in 60. It must be a camera thing. I mean, that's the only other. I guess it maybe could be a VTX thing, but I really doubt it. Weird. Yeah, I guess I'll try different. I need to try a different camera on the one chase rig here because this OV231 has shit the bed. The lens is coming off, so I do need to switch the camera out on this. So I'll try something different and maybe, yeah, I don't know. I'm very sad that this 231 has actually fallen apart because. This is an OG camera. I might be able to bond to get back together. I'll try it, but we'll see. Walter says, better preparation next time. I'm interested. Thanks. What do you mean? What do you mean by better preparation next time? Walter also says, you would like 360 cam. I don't really like 360 cams. There's
even when you zoom them properly, there's, I don't know, just, they always feel weird to me. They're awful heavy. I don't know. I'm not a 360 cam fan. I think they're cool, but not for me. Traffic says something seriously wrong. Still blame OBS. Yeah, that's true. OBS does hammer the hell out of the processor. Yeah, like for example, just running OBS. All right, so that's what's going on. Yeah, OBS is just using up all the stank the computer. If I were to unplug a couple of these cameras, the OBS is also extra stanky because I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 sources running into it at any given time. Kilo Zebra says, did you record both with the same DVR? No. The previous 60 frames was from the Immersion RC Power Play. So yeah, I guess to check the HDZero, I need to hook... I'll fart around with it. Traffic AU says you are doing it wrong. You ought to use linear video editing hardware for that look. I'll get out the razor blades. Freelo just says maybe it new Premiere match frame rate thing. I'm not sure what that means. Cole Power says HDZero deinterlacer will turn 60i into 60p. But then why is the file, why does it, yeah, why does it have this? I'll myth bust that for sure by just hooking the Immersion RC Power Play up. But yeah, that's interesting. I mean, I can't say that I have ever had the full 60 frames coming out of the HDZero goggles. I'm just assuming that since it's giving me a 60 frame file, that's interesting. If I have to keep using the power play through the goggles, that's fine. Is there a, whatever. I'll play around with that. Not on stream. Gilly Zebra says that's probably the problem. Different dealer, you know, deinterlacing algorithm, on HDZero versus power play. I might be able to, this camera came out of focus when the monitor exploded. There we go. Well, maybe it's just. Nope, yeah, now it's right. It came out of focus when the monitor broke. Like 10 minutes before the live stream, the stand on one of my old Apple monitors just exploded. and it just like knocked everything everywhere. All right, so that's good to go. It's 8:30. There was another little bit of mailbag that I wanted to do. Yeah, hey, continuation of mailbag. This is a box from Douglas Otwell, the beautiful bastard that has created and manufactures the gangly fans. I got down to like one gangly fan, and he actually noticed it when I noticed it. And he was like, yo, you need more? I'm like, hell yeah, I do. And so here's another box of beautiful gangly fans. Join the Patreon if you want a chance to win a gangly fan. One gets given away every single... Well, I guess you don't have to join the Patreon, but do it anyway. Support me, yo. For $3 a month, you will get an awful lot more benefit than what you're paying for. And you'll support a gangly bastard. Who doesn't want to support a gangly person? Metadarsin says, it's an NTSC thing from the early days of color TV. 60 is actually $59.94, for old legacy reasons, I don't remember. Yeah, I used to know why they had the weird numbers as well back in school. Back at uni! Let's chop out a little bit more junk, and then we'll do a little bit of flying, and then we'll... Nah, let's just fly. Let's just fly, friends. We chopped some of it up. I'm really annoyed that the, that it's running so poorly with 640 by 480 footage. Let's fly a couple of different rigs, actually. Let's go... Well, screw it. Let's go around the horn. We'll fly a bunch of different stuff. We're going to fly the indestructible rig that's real heavy and fat. We're going to fly the ultralight Mobula 6 2024. And then we'll fly the ultimate freestyle tiny whoops that are kind of in between. First, let's go ass opposite ends of the spectrum. We're going to go indestructible, and then we're going to go Mobula 6 2024. So, dry weights, here's what you're about to see. First, you're going to see 19.8 grams dry with 802 27,000 kV motors on tri-blades. Then you're going to see 17.1 grams again on tri-blades, and then we'll keep going on the tri-blades. Then we're going to go this is 28,000 kV. That's the second thing that you're going to see. Then you're going to see 32,000 kV at 18.1 grams, and then you're going to see 36,000 kV at 18 grams. Right on the nose. Yeah, let's do a little bit of flying here. I need a transmitter. And yeah, I probably need to bounce back and forth on modules at some point here. So let's get that extra module. I'm just gonna fat shark it because they're comfy and lightweight and amazing. Ah. Okay, hold on. I need to turn that off. Actually, there's five sources coming in. There's five video sources coming into OBS. The HD's, the Elgato box, the main camera here, the analog that you're looking at the snow from, and then the two webcams. So yeah, OBS is working for it. This is going to be a beta FPV lava battery first. And this is the indestructible rig, 18 point something grams. I don't know if this is the right module. We'll find out together. It is! Look at that. I'll leave the OSD on for you. Here we go! Indestructible tiny whoop that you can't build. Damn, does it fly decent though. Oh god! Hey! Let's go upstairs with this big fat cow. This is on the Gemfan 1208 tri-blades. Hey, Teddy Spaghetti! An attack from a small dog. There he is. What's he gonna do? Oh, he's gonna get it. He's gonna get it. Look at that nose. He looks like a goddamn stuffed animal. I never get sick of it. Oh boy. Hey, this thing is incredible, man. For how heavy it is, it boogies. Oh god, that fan is ripping. Oh god! Oh, Teddy tried to eat me. Oh, fart. I think I'm in a shoe. I'm in a shoe. Shit! All right, hang on. I was in a shoe indeed. All right. Here we go. Whoo, shit. Oh, come on now. Oh, God, why? Oh, God, why? Oh, we just go from unrecoverable to unrecoverable, my friends. I am now inside of my flight bag. Maggie got me a 90-inch diameter burrito blanket for my birthday. That's what you're looking at here. So I now have two massive burrito blankets. Man, I can't fly worth a fuck tonight. Most nights. Oh my God, I'm in a weird spot right now. Oh, no, no, don't. Oh, come on, you fucking asshole. Come on, you jerk off. Get me off. Oh, boy. Didn't mean to say that. Oh, man. This is maddening. Stop it, Teddy. I'm not in the mood. Oh, you fuck! Jesus. Hell. Woo, God. We got through that gate in a hurry. Oh, my goodness. I put a big hit of y'all roll in there to correct where I was and get it into that gate. Teddy, let me out. Teddy, come on, let me out. I can't just go up. I'm under the thing. Teddy! Let me go! He made a noise that was really weird. Sounded like an indigestion or something. There we go. Stop it! Let me go! The runtime on this rig sucks because it's so heavy. Oh man, he was coming after me. Oh! I almost got out of there clean. This thing flies really good for being so heavy. But the weight is very noticeable. It is like very obviously heavy and carries its momentum like a son of a bitch. But for what it is, it flies really, really good. And I think it might actually be indestructible with the 1.5 mil motor shafts. But I'm not like, I have to be flying good to fly this rig properly. Cause it is heavy. So let's go complete opposite ends of the spectrum to the Mobile 6 2024, with the RunCam Nano 3 camera and the old school Mobula canopy on it to bring it down to 17.1 grams. This is a old battery. Not an old battery, but an older battery. And I guess this rig is on ELRS 3.0, so let me switch the module. There we go. Timmons says, do you have an original Ultimate Freestyle Tiny Whoop from years back to compare to the newest one? No. It's been... It's been a formula that has, like, just sort of developed over time. You know, like, the original version of it was on, like, 802 25,000s and, like, God knows what frame. Yeah, it's just been something that has evolved. There wasn't, like, an original version of it, per se. Ah, yeah, buddy. Come on now. Come on. Get in the groove. Oh, yes! Yeah, so lightweight rigs are easier to fly, my friends. Like, for real. This is not necessarily like me all of a sudden flying better. Yeah, this is me flying a rig that's easier. That is easier to fly. With less weight, it's going to be more like a scalpel in that whatever you point it at, that's where it's going to go. It really makes a huge difference, as you can see. Oh, come on. Don't do that. Oh, God. That didn't look very good, but hey. Shit. I tried to get a little... Oh, man. What if I hit that? What if I hit the coffee table power loop, but in the opposite direction? Can you imagine if I managed to drop it down between the couch? Drop it down between the couch and the coffee table? Like that, and then catch it and fly back under. Oh, I don't even know if I want to bother trying that, because that's, I don't think that's a possibility. Don't you dare. Possibility. Oh, shit! Oh, God, I'm on my desk. I thought I was on the, I thought I was over there on top of that thing. Never arm on your workbench. You'll blow all your screws everywhere. Ugh. Hey, yeah! Oh, come on! God damn you. Ah, so close. That second gate got me. Fuck off. Come on. Nope. Damn. I don't think that's for... Hey! Ah, I'd move that bag out of there. Ooh, that was cool looking. Look at the runtime on this thing. God damn. This is a battery that's been beat up pretty good. Hold on. We're going to do another battery on this guy. this is a RunCam Nano 3 from the Emacs Nanohawk, and it's really bright. Apparently there are a lot of different RunCam Nano... I know that there's a lot of different RunCam Nano 3s, but it's becoming more and more apparent that they have drastically different, like, exposure algorithms on them. And so, yeah, they look really different. If you want one that looks like this, it's going to be a direct wire version that you can get from GetFPV. And it's meant, like I said, for the Emacs Nanohawk. All right, here we go. And away we go. This is a Beta FPV lava battery. Come on, you son of a bitch. What? Where was it? Where was the gate? Oh my God. This is so light. Ah! Oh my God. Oh my goodness. So that was crash recovery actually locking me out a little bit. I might have caught that. Jesus. No. Get me out of here. Yes. Ah, what the... I don't know what I was thinking there. Apparently I thought that thing would get out of the way. Jesus. Oh well. Oh, come on now. What's wrong with me? Oh, that was a fucking wing and a prayer on that one. Oh my God. Almost. Not almost. Oh God. Oh God. Hold on for dear life. Just keep holding on. Oh, that was such a sloppy attempt. Oh, I'm really getting like super sloppy about trying to get into this dive tunnel. I don't know why I think I can, like, I know better. I know that I have to be dialed in to get in there, and then with any kind of chance of getting out of the damn thing. Ah! Big power loop's tough, man. Oh, boy. That was something else entirely. Ah! That would have been so sick. God damn it. Get out of there. Oh! Oh! Oh, shit. Don't break anything. Oh, I keep forgetting to turn this little light on. Why is this room so bright? Oh, I don't have the I'm stupid. I didn't set the lights in the room right. There we go. That'll be cooler looking. And a lot less bright. That's why it was so bright in here. There we go. Yeah, it looks much more normal. I shouldn't have disarmed. Let's just chill out for a minute. Ooh, I got lucky on that one. No! I couldn't decide to go to the left or the right, so I went right into the base of the chair. Oh, God, it's so small down there. Nope. Oh, this is not going well. Get me out of here. Oh, my God, what was that? I guess I caught the bottom of the burrito. What was that? That was a very awkward moment. 3 minutes and 40 seconds. Good God, man. Lightweight fixes everything. Jesus. Unbelievable. Okay, so there is ultra fat and then ultra light. Not really ultra fat, but definitely ultra light. Now we're going to stick on the tri-blade train and go to the 32,000 kV 0702 Ultimate Freestyle Tiny Whoop setup with a tattoo battery that's been cycled a bunch, but not to death. All right. Here we go. This is like low 18s, 18.3 grams, I think. Free Lojo, thank you for dropping the Patreon link into the chat there. Off access with the CiottiFPV.com link. Thank you, dude. Jeremy asks, what is a gangly fan? It's a little desktop fan to keep your stuff cool with a really cool little logo on it. Gangly Gang logo on it. Timon says, we got that. Curtis Hayes says, get in the groove, boy, you gotta prove your love to me, Madonna in the 90s. Jeremy says, I got a magnetic tray to keep my screws from going everywhere. Yeah, my mat is magnetic, but it'll still blow them all over the place. It's wild. Curtis Hayes says, one thing I've learned watching, you get better by not worrying about crashing. And Seattle would say, no, I would not say that. crashing is very, it's just hysterical. Maybe it's because I come from motorsport where like you really kind of can't crash. The fact that we can crash these things a million times and not like kill ourselves or destroy them or whatever, I just find to be hysterical. And yeah, I crash a lot. Also, if you want to get better, you got to push yourself a little bit beyond your limits. It's about all those things. This rig is on the... here's another thing that just happened to occur is that we're flying all of the different propellers too. The first rig was on Gemfan 1208s. The second rig was on Gemfan 1219s. This guy is on the HQ YOLO props. The first rig was on 802s. Second rig and the rest of these are on 702s. We're trying. Wow. We're trying all the different propellers. And the last rig that we fly in a minute here, I was trying to move my finger on the transmitter. Last rig we're going to fly is going to be on the... Oh, boy. Gemfan 1610 biblades. I wanted to try to drop it down to the cube, but it just didn't work out. I was just a little bit off. Oh God, don't hit me. Oh, I can't decide. I went on Facebook for the first time in like 2 weeks and instantly got into a fight with a fucking moron. So that was interesting. That was very annoying. But that's Facebook. A place for people that know nothing to hang out. Oh! That little bump. Oh, shit. Oh! I didn't really line that up. I just made it go backwards in hopes that it would go through the gate. Oh my God, I caught just the edge of the damn thing. That was sucked. That's how you cheat a Maddie flip exit. Oh my God, what did I even hit on that? Ah! Man, I'm having a hard time with Maddie's tonight. Oh my God, I'm having a hard time with everything tonight. Jesus hell. Oh, fart. Come on, let me out. Yay. Oh my God. For the record, when I say HQ YOLO props, these are the HQ ultralight tri-blades. I call them YOLO props because you only use them once, and then they're all bent up. It's not that bad, but yeah, they're the most fragile tiny whoop props for sure. That's why they're so light. I really wanted that dive. Ah! Yeah. Yeah. If you're wondering why my rigs are bouncing off of stuff so easily, it's these cockroach 65 V3 frames. The propeller actually rides closer to the center of the duct. So a lot of times when you bump into stuff, it won't stall the props out. Pretty much all the other frames, the propeller rides too low in the duct and it hits the supports to the frame. So yeah, that's one of the big things that I really, really, really like about the cockroach 65 V3 frame. Last rig we're going to fly is the ultimate freestyle tiny whoop with the 36,000 KV motors and the Gemfan bi-blades. This will actually be interesting. I've been flying tri-blades quite a bit lately. Hopefully this is a triumphant return to bi-blades. The 36,000 KV motors are an awful lot. They're hard to fly. But let's give it a shot. Oh my God. Oh boy. It's gonna take me a minute to adjust. Oh! Oh my God. I love these bi-blade props. I don't know what it is, but they just connect with my brain so nicely. And then the mega KV, hold on, I'm holding the transmitter all weird. The mega KV of these motors is just hysterical. No, what am I doing? Where am I going? I don't know what I'm doing. Oh, hey, oh, where am I going? This is a new route. Oh, God, okay. Easy. Oh. Oh, you. It was all going so well. Oh, I gotta remember to blip the throttle to get it to stop carrying. I love this little move. I love this, like, in here, and then... Oh! I also can't forget this one. This is a good one here, too. That's a fun one that I just recently figured out. But this box is kind of in the way. Oh, boy. That is just a... Hey, by the way, friends, my parents got me these wheels for this chair to not wreck the carpet. I did a little bit of research, and yeah, apparently you can put these big rollerblady wheels on your chair. I fucking love them, yo. I love these rollerblady wheels. They're on Amazon. Yeah, look at them. Yeah, bounce, bitch, bounce. My God, these things, the flight performance of these goddamn tiny whoops is just next level. Having all the weight centralized, really just like, the yaw axis is on crack. Oh! Come on. Hey! Just a little touch there, just you know. A mirror flip going. Oh, that was a good mirror flip. Oh, no! The idiot that I got into an argument with on Facebook. Never mind. Whoa! All right, so we got a little bit of jello. These props are either beat up, or maybe these motors are beat up. I've tortured these motors pretty good. Apparently, RC... Apparently, RCinpower is working on an 0702. That's super exciting. Hopefully, they make it a somewhat worthwhile KV. Oh God, it's in a weird spot. Ah, yeah. Not that weird of a spot. I don't know if Bot's live streaming tonight. Jeremy says, do you use air mode or straight acro? So it's not one or the other. Acro refers to the accelerometer not being on. And so air mode has pretty much nothing to do with acro. Acro is if you're not using the accelerometer. So basically, if you're not in horizon or angle mode, then you're in acro. And then air mode is something that you can turn on in acro. And yes, I do use air mode. With all of the off-throttle stuff that I do, I have to have air mode. Without air mode, when you go zero throttle and throw it across the room like this, it's going to wobble all over the place. Air mode is super important for doing the kind of ridiculous shit that I'm always trying to do. Here's a Beta FPV lava battery. Hold on. Let me go into turtle mode real quick and spin each propeller up to see if we can figure out where that jello is coming from. Turtle mode, arm. That's motor 2. Not too bad. Motor 1 is kind of beat up. 3 is fine. 4 is pretty beat up. And I think it's the motors. Yeah, the propellers look fine. I think it's the motors that are banged up. Which is fine. I torture these poor things. At some point, I'll throw new props on, though, because it could be prop-related. Matter Ertzen says, Bots in an event said he might try streaming remotely, but it may not happen. And then Freeloja says, have you heard about the app BlueSky? I have not. What is that? Whoa, big fella. Let's go upstairs with these mega KV motors. Pay Teddy a little visit. Teddy Spaghetti is a maniac! Oh my God, where am I? Oh boy! He over the goddamn place. My God, this thing feels so good up here. Oh, shit. The fucking bonsai stairwell entry. My God, if I could have pulled that off, I'd still be screaming now. Oh. Teddy's been hanging out down here a lot lately. Can you tell? Can you tell? Can you tell how much he's been hanging out down here lately? He does this thing where, like, he brings a toy to you, and he just stares at you. And if you don't throw it, he runs upstairs, and he grabs another one. And then he just does that until all of his toys are at a pile in front of you, or on your lap, or on your face. Yay! Oh, I've never done that before. That's a terrible idea. I should not do that. Let's try it again. It's not too bad. It's not too sketchy. The bar cart has a bunch of shit that I don't want to break, so I always try to not interact with the bar cart. But we got a quick power loop. Now I can just never do it again. It's fine. Ah, let's just rocket into the ceiling. Good idea. Oh, don't. Just be cool. Yeah, there we go. All you gotta do is get the duct out from under the lip when that happens. And you can usually do it by just, like, doing exactly what I was just doing there. Like, lift it up into the lip. Sometimes it... What the fuck? Sometimes it won't cooperate. But if you just keep trying for long enough, you can waste the entire battery. Oh, yeah. Oh, boy. This is me, like, trying to not crash. It's not fun. You know, like not crashing is not fun. Freeloader says, BlueSky is a social media app. Not interested. I need less social media in my life, not more. In theory, it's a good social media app, though, maybe, that doesn't murder children. All right, last battery of the live stream, friends. Go see if Botgrinder is streaming. I'm in his time slot. Hopefully he is. If not, I will see you guys again Sunday at 3 o'clock. No matter what, I'll see you again at Sunday at 3 o'clock. 36,000 KV with Biblades. Here we go. Okay. Oh, boy. Oh, you son of a bitch, you. Stop it. Leave me alone. I'm gonna fly this one for fun, so prepare for crashing. Oh my God. Man, on a fresh battery, these motors with these props are quite the thing. I wanted to throw... come on, man. This has not been a great night of flying for me. Some nights I got it, tonight ain't one of those nights. I'm now gonna spend this entire battery trying to get it out, rather than just walking 4 feet over. No, we're good. It's fine. Oh my God, the yaw response. The yaw is just obnoxious. Ooh, that mirror flip. That's one of the better ones ever. Mega power loop. Oh, so close. Easy. Let's try it again. Oh my God, I did not have anywhere near the height that I needed for that. What the hell? Oh, for fuck's sake. Hey, I can't usually get it out of there. God damn. It is a hell of an adjustment to these motors. Because I have not been flying them a lot lately. I've been flying the lower KV stuff. Ah, rejected. Oh! Shit. No. I had zero forward momentum for that. Oh, God, get in there. Okay. Oh, I wanted to let it. What? How is it possible that?
Where is it that it's constantly black? That was weird. It was like wedged in the side a little bit. That was very weird.
Yeah. There's a duck. All right, come on. Careful! God! This room is so small for these motors. Oh, why you gotta do that to me? Don't be mean. Coffee table power low. Nope. Come on. Ah! Coffee table power loop is one of the hardest things in here, and it just does not look like it. It does not look as difficult as it is. Oh, God, what? Where am I going? Ah! Hold on. Ah! Man, I'm having a really hard time with Matty Flips tonight. I gotta get at least one, though. Oh, you bastard! I mean, technically that was one, but it was ugly and disgusting. Oh my god! Way too early on the throttle blip with that. Oh my god, I can't keep it off. That's it. This battery's done. Don't ruin the battery. There it is, friends! Thanks for hanging out. My name's Aaron Ciotti. Everybody calls me Ciotti. Suck it, Trebek! Hold on. Jeremy says, is there something special that you do to get the crash mode to work so well? It's terrible on my Mabio 6. Yeah, you have to tune it. There is an article over on... you got to tune it for your rates and for how hard you crash. Over on the Betaflight wiki, there is a great chunk of text about it. Let's see if I can hook you up with a link real quick. Did I save it? Let's see. Did I save it here? I did not. So here's how you find it. You go to the Google machine and you search for Betaflight wiki. And the Betaflight wiki has so much cool stuff on here. This is an incredible resource. Up in the search, if you search for crash recovery, it will bring you right in here. And this is the section that you want to read. It breaks it all down. It talks about the crash recovery angle, the crash recovery rate, and there's a third one. Here's the link in the chat. I forget what the third one is. Hold on. It's the G threshold. So the point where crash recovery turns on is when it sees a big spike in G-force. And if you're crashing into like metal stuff versus these ripstop nylon gates, it's gonna be a little bit different. So get crash should show me everything. Yeah, so that is okay. So
You can try these settings. These settings will work better than the default settings for sure. But you should play around with these a little bit. So the D threshold of 80, the default value is 50. This is D gain related. I set these so long ago that I don't really remember specifically how I set each one of these. But yeah, play around with them, you'll get them. Here's the G threshold, and I have it set to 6G instead of the default value of 4G. So that's going to keep it from activating too often. And then the set point threshold, I forget what this one is as well, but the default is 350. I have it cranked up to 500. I believe that's it. The recovery rate. This is how quickly it brings you back to horizontal. The default is 100. I have it cranked all the way up to 200. That's going to double it. So it recovers faster. And then, of course, you have to turn it on. But yeah, you can feel free to copy those values. They'll probably work pretty good for you. But do mess around with them. They're not super confusing. Move it. Take them one at a time and move it all the way up and then move it all the way down. And that'll show you like what it's doing. And then you're going to pick a point in the middle usually. But yeah, you don't want it to turn on too often. You don't want it to not turn on. And so, yeah, it's going to, and just understand that like when you smack into the wall, that's a very sharp hit. When you smack into like a gate that's hanging down from the ceiling, that's a much softer hit. So those sharp hits are going to have a bigger G spike. The hitting a gate is going to have much less of a G spike. Also try to just like fly. And when if it turns on too often, then you can kind of back it off a little bit, right? Like testing it is a good way to get it somewhat dialed, but like as you continue to fly, just pay attention. And if it's constantly turning on too much, then go in and fix it. Because when you're just flying, you're going to crash differently, and there's certain scenarios where you don't want it to turn on. So yeah, it really helps to kind of just fly around and then like watch your DVR back and just pay a little bit more of attention to it, and you'll get it dialed in perfect for you. Curtis Hayes says, what's a good VTX to put on the Beta FPV cross flight controller? I have a Tiny Whoop with a Zeus analog VTX and it flies like a pig. The VTX that most people run is the TBS Pro 32 Nano. I ran on my racing build the OVX something or other, and that was totally fine. There's also the Foxeer one. There's a bunch. The Weebleed sells a bunch, tinywhoop.com sells a bunch, and they both only really sell the good ones. So just order from one of those places and you'll get a good one. Thanks for hanging, friends. My name's Aaron Ciotti. Everybody calls me Ciotti. www.ciottifpv.com has a million ways you can support me. I greatly appreciate it. It is the only reason I can do this full time and spend 40 plus hours a week doing this stuff to give you really good data and testing, and I love it, and hopefully you do too. Be good, my friends. I'll see you Sunday at 3:00. Here's some more raw flight footage from the chasing them little drift cars yesterday. Hopefully it's good. I'm just picking a random file. Bye bye, friends.